Now, while you're watching this video, please remember to like, subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon for notification of future videos, and share this video also. Thank you.
Well, hello there. Welcome back to my channel, guys. Yes, so today, what we'll be talking about, as you can see, the title suggests, can Christians join Christian dating sites, apps, or groups? This is what we'll be discussing in this very short video, as you can see. Now, the reason why I've chosen to talk about something like this, the inspiration of this video actually comes from a video that I believe I did last week at this time. Right now, the recording of this video is March 19, 2021. And the reason why I'm saying this is because March 19, 2021, I uploaded a video, right? And I'm not certain as to when I'll actually get to post this. It might end up posting the next day. So I'm just stating that off the record so you know when this video was actually recorded. Right? Now, as I said just now, the inspiration of this video comes from a video I did last week where I was talking. I think the title of the video was something saying about if you're going through a situation of quote-unquote burning as a Christian. And I feel that this is something important to talk about due to the fact that we're in now in the time of a pandemic, right? You know, COVID-19 is still on, right? And the world has changed radically, right? In the blink of an eye, the world has changed. Now, I know before COVID, there are many persons who used to downplay the media and so forth. They used to talk about the many evils of the media, technology and so on. But now the minds of many Christians, I'm certain, has changed. Because right now, most Christians are reliant upon media. They're reliant upon social media and so forth. Because most countries now have restrictions where gathering is concerned. Right? So for instance, in JA, we have curfew hours. The curfew hours now is 8 p.m., right? And it ends at 5 a.m. So that means that anytime after 8 p.m., no one is supposed to be on the road. Also, no one is supposed to be in any building, right, where there is more than 10 persons at a time in it. This is what the world has gone to know. We have to social distance. And not only do we have to social distance, but we also have to be wearing masks, right? We also have to be wearing masks. Now, why I'm saying this to you know, is because for persons who are single, right, single Christians, I can well imagine, is going to be much harder right now for you to find a marriage partner in the time that we are living in. So this video is basically to cater to individuals like myself, because I am single also. It's going to be extremely difficult to find a marriage partner. Let me tell you why. Once upon a time, when churches used to have events regularly, right, where it involves persons gathering, whether it be concert and so forth, much of that is not happening now. So the chances of you finding a marriage partner, it is going to be difficult. We can't even go to church like how we used to go to church once upon a time. Whereas we could just visit church randomly, right? We can't even do that now. Because when the government set a rule in a state in that 10 persons, that's how it is in my country now, no more than 10 persons at church. Those 10 persons is basically to conduct the service. And they stream it so that you can watch it, so that the other members can watch it online. So that means that it's not wise now for you to go to random churches. Right? And these were the way in which persons, Christians, you know, actually find their marriage partner, you know. Through socializing, through going to events and so forth where single Christians will be, through visiting different churches and so on. And maybe even meeting someone on the road, whether it be a bus or somewhere, you know, you spot someone and it's like your spirit tell you, engage a conversation with this person. Your spirit tell you that, hey, this person is a Christian, you know, let me try and engage a conversation. that all of that has been totally eradicated. Because I mean, if you're on the street now, you know, and you see someone with a mask on, everyone just want to go about their business and go home, right? People want to beat the curfew hours and so forth. Nobody has any time to stop and chit chat like one time. And even if persons, I mean, think of it, look at it this way. Imagine I'm on the street, a girl have her mask and so forth, right? I don't even know who I am talking to. So how am I supposed to say, hello, pretty lady, can I have a minute of your time? Just giving an example. How am I supposed to even try to engage a conversation with her? I can't even see her face, much less. Can you imagine now, me now, supposed to approach a girl? With my mask on, worse, I brought my glasses today with me not at work, but I'm so sorry I never put it in this video. I put on my darkers, my glasses, I have on a cap, and my mask is on my face. Which woman is going to want to talk to me when I'm all strapped up? And vice versa, which guy would want to approach a girl that he can't even see? Remember now, you know, that many know, we go by what we can see. There is nothing to see, you know, so how am I supposed to just go to a female and have a conversation with her when there is nothing to see? Do you get the point that I'm actually making? So this is why I say that dating apps or sites for single Christians is the way to go right now if you don't have a marriage, if you have not yet found a spouse. Right now, if persons used to say before that it's unwise to seek to find a partner through those avenues, I'm very certain that no one can actually say that right now. It would rather be legalistic and basically foolish then, so to speak, to tell a Christian that they shouldn't go on these dating apps or dating sites, because who are you going to find a partner? So I'm saying this to say, women, it is our duty to find you, right? And because of how things are right now, it is very difficult for us to find you. Events are hardly keeping anymore, right? And because most persons, you know, they normally go to events during the night, after work, in the night and so forth. But because of this, there is little places that we can actually go to right now. And many of the places now where people used to go and sit and talk, you have to just grab a meal and basically leave. There's not much places that you can go right now. Right? So what I'm saying, Christian women who are single now, right? If you want to be found because of how things are difficult right now, I can tell you that dating apps or dating sites, it's a way in which you can put yourself out there for you to be found. Right? Christian single men, to find a wife, a counterpart right now, checking out these sites is a good way for you to actually find someone. Right? So I am affirming Christian dating apps / sites or groups. Right? I'm affirming it. Now, having affirmed it, right, there are some pros and cons, right, that I think that you all should know. Now, please pardon me because I'm doing videos on a daily basis. There are times when I don't get sufficient time to make adequate preparation. So I'm not adequately prepared to actually do this video. But I'll speak based off my own experience. Where Christian dating app is concerned, there's only one advantage that I can think of in my mind right now. That advantage is that you have an influx of persons to actually choose from, right? So it increases the possibilities of you finding someone that can actually suit your need, what you're actually looking for. And the reason why I said it is, it's convenient having an abundance to actually choose from, because when you engage a conversation on someone, with someone, and a female on this app, speaking to, well, no, I'm not going to generalize it to men. Whether men or women, or woman, you find someone and you're speaking to them on this app. You engage a conversation, you ask, well, what tell me a little bit about yourself. What is it that you state, what they're looking for in a partner? right, and so forth, and you state what you're looking for, right? And if you find that, yeah, they look the way look like we can actually know each other more, because yes, what you're looking for is what I have, right? And what I am looking for is what you have, right? So from there, you can actually start a conversation, you know, you get to know the person and you go along, right? If it so happened that that person doesn't suit your need, then hey, there's a next one that you can choose from, and a next one, and a next one. So the possibility of you finding someone will increase significantly, right? Now, let's talk about the disadvantage. And the disadvantage is, based on my experience, what I can say, it may be that the disadvantage are more than the advantages, actually, right? I could only think of one advantage right off the tip of my head, but the disadvantage, there are many that I can think of, right? And so I've observed, having checked out many some apps then and some dating groups and so forth, and hearing the testimony of persons, it seems that it's rather difficult still. Even though you have more to choose from, it is still difficult, right, for you to find a partner on these dating apps, right? And that is because the disadvantages, it's somewhat are more than the advantages, right? And now let me state the disadvantage, and I'm going to tell you how you can actually manage these disadvantages, right? Or in order to maybe manage isn't the right word, but how you can actually deal with these disadvantages. Disadvantage number one, the persons who create those dating apps, sites, or groups for Christian, it's highly unlikely that they are going to screen the persons that go on it and to find out if what they say about themselves is actually true. And so as a result of this, as you can well imagine, persons come on it and they will lie. When I say lie, they will say they are something who they are actually not, right? That's in fact perhaps one of the greatest disadvantages. Second disadvantage, you have different levels of Christians who are going to come on the app. You have the babes, right? You have the super spiritual Christians, right? You have judgmental Christians. You have, what else should I say? You have persons who are aspiring to become Christians. And then you have persons who doesn't fall in any category. They're a sinner and they just come on the app for whatever reason only God knows, right? And then you have persons who come on the app to either promote their business or so forth. Persons come on it to scam, so disingenuous persons. You're going to find these elements that will actually come on the apps. So because of this, it is your duty not to give out too much information all at once. So you're speaking to someone, they don't need to know where you work, they don't need to know where you live, until you have properly screened them and you say, hey, it's safe to actually tell them no. Right? If it is that you're going to meet someone, you know that you meet them in an area, an open area, right? That has a lot of, you know, trafficking where people is concerned. So you would essentially keep yourself safe. Right, and if you can go with someone, bring a friend or so, then that makes it all more better. Now, the other disadvantage, having an influx to choose from, you know, an abundance to choose from. It's good, as the advantage I put out, but it's also bad. And here's why it's bad. You may be in a position where you're always trying to see if you can find better than the person that you're speaking to currently. Yes, you find some things that you like about them, but there are some deterrents then, so to speak. It may be that the person might have some baggage, right? And you're saying, I wonder if I can still, you know, not lay my eggs in one basket, see if I can find someone better. So you find someone, you're looking now for someone with the same qualities without the baggage. You understand what I'm saying? Just giving a pint. You're always seeking and trying out because you're testing the waters because you have an abundance. When you check a stock, you may never end up actually settling with one because each time you're seeking to see if you can find someone better. Right? And I'm saying this to you that you have to reach a point, make a list of the core things that you're actually looking for. Right? You make a list of the core things that you're looking for. Once you find those core things, then you have to learn to compromise and accept the other things that you do not see, right? Because to find someone who fits your mold perfectly, 100%, trust me, it's highly unlikely. It's not impossible, but it's going to be very difficult. You determine if you have the time and energy to wait that long and to go through so many persons before you find someone who perfectly fits your model, right? Now, let me see if I can think of any more disadvantage. Based on the testimonies of many, they have met perverts on the app, right? Now, I hear it from so many Christian women, they met perverts. But hey, you're not alone, women. There are actually guys who actually meet women who, if you're not careful, and we all know, you know, that when it comes to men, the smaller head oftentimes get the better of us. And if you're a weak male, right, you may not want to go on these apps because you may find women that if you're not careful, you may end up get drawn out, right? Women, you know, who perhaps would say they are a Christian and they are really not, right? So these are some of the disadvantages. I can't think of any more right now, but if I do think of any, I will actually put it on the screen for you to see. I'm not thinking of any more disadvantage at the moment, right? But if there's any, just look on the screen. I will have it typed on the screen, right? Now, with that being said, I leave you guys to decide what you're going to do right where this is concerned. Now, remember the previous study, I made mention of the fact that Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 7 that it's better to marry than to burn. It's good not to touch a woman, you know, speaking to the men. But to avoid fornication, let every man have his wife. If you're in a position of burning, whether male or female, don't be there like sitting ducks, you know, men, expecting that your wife is going to drop from sky. No, you have to go out and find her yourself. Women, don't go and expect that a man is going to come and knock on your door and say, hey, hello, anyone there? Is there any single woman in the house? No, no, that's highly unlikely that that's going to happen. You have to put yourself out there to be found. Right? It's better to marry than to burn. If you're in a position, many of us Christians, we've been single for 5 years, 10 years, and more. And before we come to Christ, we have been sexually active. And we all know that once you're sexually active, you know, to just stop having sex like that, it can be quite difficult. Right? And this is why in Acts chapter 15, it likens sexual immorality, which is something that we should avoid, we should try to avoid, right, as a burden. No other burden should be laid on them than these things, and sexual immorality is one of them. It is the burden that we Christians is going to have to deal with, especially in this day and age where sex actually sells. It's hard to avoid seeing sex printed all over in the world where we are living in. Right, and so to keep ourselves sexually pure, if you realize that you cannot control yourself and you're struggling and you're burning, go on the journey in finding your counterpart. And as I've stated several times over in this video, dating app, Christian singles dating apps or sites is the way to go. Now I end this video. I do hope that you enjoyed. If you did, you know what to do. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share. And let me repeat that. If you do enjoy this video, you know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. Right? Bye-bye now.